cancer.
Yeah.
Gina, she's in the second cycle.
Of chemotherapy?
Yeah. She's been having milligram injections to boost the white blood cells.
Yeah.
Steroids. She's in her second week.
I've got it in my brain as well.
Yeah.
My speech has gone terrible.
Oh.
Yeah, because we're not sure whether this is chemo-related or the brain mets.
So the doctor's been out. He said that she's got possible neutropenic sepsis.
Possible.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Well, we're just going to do some OBS. Is that all right, Theresa? Are you happy for me just to have a quick listen to your chest?
Yeah.
All right, my darling. Yeah, we've got crackles, lower right lobe. You're very warm.
In my bag, I've got what her drugs is she's been having today. Do you need that?
Yeah, all her tablets and that, yeah.
What time are you giving her?
He's very organised, isn't he? Hey?
And everything.
Is he? Has he always been like that? Yeah.
He's very headphone.
Yeah, but it saves you having to do it. Oh, God, love you. Right. So, Theresa, what we're going to do now is get the ambulance ready for you. And then we'll carry you downstairs.
The staff at Worcester's fantastic.
But the waiting time was 6 hours. It was amazing.
Because she was again neutropenic.
Yeah.
And everybody's puking up everywhere.
Yeah.
And I was so concerned that she's very vulnerable.
When we leave here, I'll ring A&E directly and pre-warn them that we're coming in. Don't thank me.
It's been emotional.
I can imagine it is.
Chris and Christine are joining 9 other crews who are experiencing delays of up to 2 hours.
Yeah. We're going to stop in a sec.
We did call in on a heads up. We got the query nuclear unit EP sent in. They're trying to sort stuff, but it is proper broken.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, in all fairness, I'd rather stay in here with her because it's just my germs.
I'm warm now.
And you're warm now? Good.
Just to let you know, we are trying.
Yeah, that's OK. Oh, yeah.
Brilliant.
See, they're under so much pressure.
Yeah. 78 of the 350 ambulances on shift are now delayed at hospitals.
If you could just let me know, that'd be great.
Okay.
All right, cheers.
It's going pretty bad across a number of places now. Heartland's very busy again, but not causing any problems yet. Hereford, have had some cohorts. Yeah, Worcester, well, we're outside on vehicles now. Don't know how they're surviving. But say there's another 6 ambulances to come behind that, so obviously conditions are getting worse there. But the problem is every hospital that we deal with is now full to capacity. And still quite a number of jobs outstanding in Worcestershire as well. So we are struggling.
Delays across the region's hospitals are becoming critical, tying up almost a quarter of the ambulances on shift. Strategic Commander Michelle's job is to take charge of the worsening situation.
So, have they opened up the corridor? So, when you say they're in the Sharnet... No, but I'd... OK, what about the ITU corridor? Well, they're going to have to do something, because they can't have patients sat on the back of ambulances. So, if they refused to open that...
Yeah.
OK.
OK, yes,
so they need to open that corridor.
She's using it as 6 now. 16 trucks here. You comfortable, Theresa? If your bottom starts hurting, let me know. It is. Okay. We have a problem here. We're just going to have a word to see how long. We have got an open pressure sore on her bottom, and she's in some discomfort.
Do you need a new bottom?
Yeah, she does, yeah.
Okay, I'll go and ask.
Should I put a smaller cuff on? That's far too big for your arm.
Yeah, she's lost a lot of weight. Isn't your baby?
Did you want a sip of water, Teresa? Mm. Yeah? Can I put this back on now?
Yeah.
Yeah, a drop in again.
Okay.
Nasty chest infection, aren't you? Shall I leave that there? I'll give it to your husband and he's got it then if he needs it. Right.
That's my wife on our wedding day.
Oh. Bit of a stunner on your wedding day.
Huh. Come on.
We're going to go into that little side room. There's somebody else in there, but...
There's another patient in there?
Yeah.
I would rather stay here.
Do you want to go and see?
I ain't having it.
Is there another patient
still
here?
Just relax, OK?
It's over there, big room.
Yes, don't worry, it's being sorted.
No worries. Mm.
You just relax on there.
Yeah.
You're in the best place to be.
We'll do the worrying and the sorting. You just relax, okay? Just relax. We're sorting.
Okay.
Being on the front line, the demand has increased immensely. Whatever role you're in, whether it's the police force, whether it's the fire brigade, whether it's the hospital staff, there is a lot more stress and it isn't getting any easier.
It ain't happening.
Staying on here.
I said, my patient is not coming off my vehicle and going in a small room with another patient that potentially could infect us, so it ain't happening. So we'll sit here till you've got a room. So. We've got a room coming up. They're just preparing it.
Oh, it's brilliant. Thank you ever so much.
I promised you wouldn't, didn't I?
She's like you. She's all guns blazing.
That's the thing. You're my priority, Teresa.
Thank you.
You're more than welcome. You'd do the same for me, wouldn't you, Chuck?
Yeah, they're okay.
Good for you, Chris.
Told her.
Good for you. They're going to move in there.
An hour and 20 minutes after arriving, Teresa can finally leave the ambulance and be admitted to hospital. 12 crews are still waiting and unable to accept new jobs.
For everybody at this time, it's an extremely hard job. I'm sure this keeps my thigh muscles in order. I just keep positive and do the best I can. The day I can't help a patient, that's the day that I'll give up.
See my day.